banks repeatedly put its own interests ahead of the interests of its clients. That was the start of a stinging attack delivered by US senators today as they began grilling several of the bank's executives. Goldman Sachs is accused of profiting from the housing disaster. The bank denies the allegations. From Washington, Adam Brooks has sent this report.
Goldman Sachs is well and truly in the dock now. The American government's charged the firm with fraud for its role in the financial crisis, and its most senior executives, Wall Street royalty, are having to explain themselves to Congress. But all eyes today were on this man, Fabrice Tour, the 31-year-old French employee of Goldman Sachs who called himself Fabulous Fab. He, we're told, helped design some of the dodgy derivatives that nearly broke the global economy. Today, he showed little contrition.
I deny categorically the SEC's allegations, and I will defend myself in court against this false claim. The last week has been challenging for me and my family, as I have been the target of unfounded attacks on my character and motives.
But from the senators came searing indictments.
You have less oversight and less regulation as you all began this wild, wild west of tranches, waterfalls, equity tranches, residual, warehousing. As you began all that, you had less oversight than a pit boss in Las Vegas.
The world's leading investment bank stands accused of fraud, of betting against its own clients in the US property market. Goldman Sachs, it's alleged, broke the law in the way a complex financial product was created and marketed ahead of the crash. Mr. Tour, the man behind the product, appears to have seen the crash coming in emails he wrote to female friends in January 2007. There is a risk the entire edifice will collapse at any moment, he wrote. Sole potential survivor, the Fabulous Fab, standing in the middle of all these complex, highly leveraged, exotic trades, created without necessarily understanding all the implications of those monstrosities. It all seems to reinforce a growing public sense that something's rotten on Wall Street.
So this is President Obama's next big challenge, to make new laws that will rein in the activities of Goldman Sachs and the rest of Wall Street. The battle to make those new laws is underway now in the building behind me, the US Congress, and it looks like it'll come to a head in the next few days. Adam Brooks, BBC News, Washington.
A coroner's call.